KSU, I'm Kelsey Lafrenay.
I'm Kimberly Pauls, and this is KSSH News at Noon.
Taking a cue from the President's State of the Union Address, Superintendent Peplinski chose our PEAC to deliver his first ever State of the Schools Address.
Here's the recap.
Hi, Santa Sue. My name is Haley Heisler, and on April 27th, Dr. Peplinski came to speak in our PEAC about the state of our schools. Let's go check it out.
The reason why we're here tonight is an effort to really make sure our community is all speaking the same language about our school district and what vision we have for the district, what goals we have for the district, and what are the facts and the fiction about what you may have heard about some of our schools.
What's your main goal for our district? For those who could not attend, where can they view it now?
After 4 years of high school,
a few of our seniors start out.
One, two, three,
four. Hi, Santa Sue. I'm Haley Hayes. The votes are in. Now let's go see our top 10 most interesting seniors. Number 10.
All right, what makes you the 10th most interesting senior?
Well, you see, I don't know.
Number 9.
I don't know, I paid for my spot here.
Number 8.
I think the most interesting thing is when I defeated the Titan Lord and saved the world.
Number 7.
I am an Eagle Scout stand-up comic, and I just enlisted in the Air Force.
Do you have any stand-up comic things?
Nothing appropriate.
How could you prove to me that pandas are real? What is your opinion on the banana versus orange war? If you were trapped on a desert island, what would be the dominant species on that island?
I believe in bananas.
Well, if we focus the camera over here.
Thank you.
You notice?
I do, yeah.
Trolls or something. They're pretty cool.
Passion is my art.
I think you mean art is my passion.
I'm happy to announce that Simi Valley Art Association has a scholarship program that they're going to be sponsoring for seniors only. And there's going to be two scholarships awarded. The first one is for $300. The second one is for $200. The categories are oil, acrylic, watercolor, pastel, drawing, printmaking, photography, and digital art, and then also mixed media. The deadline for files to be submitted is May 21st, and those digital files can either be submitted to me, Mrs. Schulte, or Mrs. Sherbach-Boyd, if you have 2D art, and then if you're a photography student and you want to submit photography samples or digital files, those would go to Mr. Abbey.
Some seniors already know which colleges they'll be attending.
That's where I'm going.
Hi, Kimberly Paul's here with Mrs. Wigdor. What is the map of acceptance?
The map of acceptance is in the hallway just outside of the offices, and it is a place for seniors to show where they have been accepted to colleges.
How can students get on the map?
Students can get on the map by coming and filling out a form that lets me know where they've been accepted to, and it is for acceptances. It's not just for places where students are committing. Students can get the form in the CCC, and then they just fill it out, and they turn it back into the box that we have available, and you fill it in whether you're going to a two-year, a four-year, off to the military, wherever it is that you're going for college, come in and fill out the form.
Back to you in the studio.
Santa Susana's award-winning yearbook is back.
Don't miss your chance to get one.
In past years, what we've done is we've made interactive CDs or DVDs, but this year we've worked in combination with an app called Geneo to make a fully virtual yearbook. So if you guys download the Geneo app, you can come to the art room, Mr. Abbey's room, anytime at lunch, and you can take a look at some of the content we have for this year's yearbook, which is over 1,000 new pictures, videos, music, and, as I promised, senior quotes.
I would like to remind all of you to buy your yearbooks now because they're $100 and they're going to be going up to $110 in a week.
Santa Sue's Film Department presents A Night of Original Films for Your Enjoyment.
Done here. Santa Susana's teachers are just as creative as the students that go here. Let's go meet one.
So, Mr. Lappin, what instrument did you play in the band?
I'm a bass player, and I played mostly Fender jazz bass. On a few songs, I played a stand-up bass.
What made you decide to become a musician?
When I was in high school, about your age, I started playing with a band, and I got into it because my friends were doing it, and for the chicks.
Where did you guys start off playing?
For my most famous band, we started out playing around, like most bands do in the clubs in Hollywood. Once we had a record deal, we moved to doing tours of the United States, of Europe, and tours of a good chunk of the Western-speaking world.
So what type of genre was your most famous band?
The band was called Zug's Rift, and it was, I guess you could classify it as avant-garde rock. We had a lot of unusual time signatures, some discordance, and sometimes all the musicians would be playing in a different key at the same time.
So where can we find your band's music?
Mostly you can find it on the internet. There's a lot of bootlegs of our live concerts. The albums that I think we did, 15 albums, those are available probably for vinyl stores or getting them, you know, off the net. There are some on iTunes. Overall, I've done over 30 albums.
A rose is a rose from the anchor with the nose for news.
I'm Sarah Tran, the 2015 to 2016 president of California Scholarship Federation, and I know you've been counting down the days until finals. If you are struggling with a specific school subject, then CSF offers a handy tutoring program every day from Monday to Thursday, after school from 3 to 4, in Mr. Alonso's room, which is room 108. I know that you can't wait for finals, and finals can't wait for you. So you can come in any day you're available for free tutoring by the same students who have passed a class that makes you cry now.
This is it, Santa Sue. Less than a month left. Lots to do, lots to think about.
It's time for the moment you've been waiting for.
The best way to prepare for finals is to go ahead and look at what you've done already in the semester, and specifically pay attention to things that you may not have gotten on the first try. Review that information, preferably with someone in the class who already knows. Touch base with your teachers, because of course everyone's interested in seeing you be successful. There may be additional resources available to you. I'd also say that you should probably run by CSF tutoring, available in Mr. Alonso's room days after school. That would be a really great resource, especially if you have a specific question about a particular academic topic.
We have a very intelligent student body, and here's our chance to prove it.
Are you interested in joining Acadeca? Let's see the team's coach, Mr. Dudak, for more info.
So to join Acadeca, you just have to come to our meeting and come speak with me. And if you show some interest, and you are welcome to join.
Are there any requirements to join?
So the only requirements to join Academic Decathlon is, one, that you're an eligible student to participate in outside of school activities. So you need to have a 2.0 or greater and be currently passing your classes. The requirements for myself are that you're interested in learning, that you are going to be, you know, here to every meeting, and that you're going to be studying and preparing for the competition.
How did we do last year?
So last year in our division, we actually placed second place, which is the best place that I've gotten here at Santa Susana as a coach. Our kids did a great job. Our last year's topic was about alternatives in energy. And this next year's topic, for those of you that are interested, is all about India. You can put this on your college applications. Doing Academic Decathlon in the past couple years has been great. I've met a lot of great students, and students have made great bonds with other people that are in the team with them. As well as that, the actual winning team for Academic Decathlon for the United States wins scholarships for college.
Back to you in the studio.
Cafe Troubadour, Droth Nye. Check this out.
Honey, dinner's ready.
Mom, get out! I get no privacy here.
Grant, come inside. I made you dinner.
Mom, I'm leaving. I'm getting on a plane and I'm going.
In Brooklyn with a frown upon my face. Just left Wisconsin where there's cheese enough to start this rat race. But thanks to the brothers Wright, we don't know where we'll sleep tonight. Yeah, I'm a bird in the sky, and tomorrow when I rise I'll wake up.
I just had the time of my life when I bought my Cafe Troubadour plane tickets with Student Store Airlines. Oh, and you should too.
With that brand new pet I met in Stuttgart. Sky's the limit, it's time to play. I'll put down roots some other day.
And after all that singing, there's dancing. If you are certifying, receiving scholarships or awards at the May 18th Senior Awards Ceremony, you must RSVP in order to attend.
And everyone, you've got just 2 days to get your mom something that makes her feel special.
And don't forget grandma, great grandma, or your very favorite matriarchal figure.
How about this?
Here's a quick and simple way to make a personalized gift for your mother. It's a garden!
Start by picking out your mother's favorite flowers, then get all your materials. You will need a tire, your flowers, and a shovel. Pick the area you want your tire and clean it up. If there are too many weeds like mine, this also gives you dirt to fill your tire with. Put the dirt in your tire. Then put your flowers in the tire in the formation of your choice. Water your flowers. Lastly, clean up your area. And you're left with a beautiful garden for your mother.
I can do that.
Sure you can. And seniors, don't forget.
May 22nd is senior barbecue, 10:30 a.m. to 2:30 p.m.
And that's the way it is.
May 7th, 2015.
Have a simply splendid day, Santa Sue.